Hello everyone, today I want to introduce a new ASIC miner repair tool, an automatic electric iron desoldering gun. It operates at an input voltage of 220 volts to 240 volts, and has a power of 140 watts. The temperature can be set between 160 degrees Celsius to 480 degrees Celsius, and it's widely used in repairing miners' power supplies and hash boards. Now, let me introduce the functions of this tool, and how to assemble it. This is the main unit, with an LCD screen on top for real-time temperature monitoring. Up for increasing the temperature, down for decreasing the temperature, and the last one is the Celsius to Fahrenheit switch button. This is the suction pump indicator. On the left is the soldering iron heating connector, and on the right is the vacuum pump connector. On the back of the main unit, there is an AC input power port, and a switch. Next, let's assemble this repair tool. And now it's assembled. Turn on the power, then flip the switch. Press the switch button to select between Celsius and Fahrenheit modes. The highest temperature that can be set is 480 degrees Celsius. Press the middle button to lower the temperature. On the screen, the lower row is the set temperature, and the upper row is the actual temperature of the desoldering gun. Now, I will demonstrate how to use it. This is the desoldering gun switch. Aim the nozzle at the pin of the component we want to remove, and after the solder melts, press this switch to clear the solder. For different pins, we need to use nozzles of different diameters. If the pins are covered with insulating glue, it also needs to be removed. Adding flux to the pins can help melt the solder faster. Then start using the desoldering gun to remove the solder. Okay, the MOS tube has been successfully removed. Let's continue to remove these types of solid capacitors. We just removed the MOS tube using a 1.5 mm nozzle. This time, we're removing small pin capacitors, and need to switch to a 1.0 mm nozzle. Then turn on the switch, and it heats up rapidly to the set temperature. Similarly, first add flux to the pins to speed up the melting of the solder, then start desoldering to easily remove the capacitor. Next, let's see how to quickly remove the I/O interface on the hash board. Apply flux to each pin, and remove the solder paste. Very good, that completes the removal. Finally, let's understand the maintenance of this tool. After each use, it's recommend to empty suck 3 to 5 times to clear the remaining solder in the tube. If the suction power decreases, use a cleaning needle to clear the steel tube. For cleaning the glass tube, flick the green switch upwards. Hold the rear end of the glass and pull back, then remove the front end to take out the glass tube, and clean the solder residue inside. Of course, the sponge here also needs to be replaced after long-term use. After all these steps, reinstall it back. That's how to use the electric desoldering gun, convenient and fast, speeding up repair work. We welcome your inquiries and orders.